Clarke Quay is situated at the River Valley Road, Singapore. The MRT line is Purple Line and the station name known as Clarke Quay. To go back to the Clarke Quay history during 1800s, Clarke Quay was known as a dock for loading and unloading of cargoes for the warehouses and commercial houses with its situation along the Singapore River. In the late 1989, it developed into commercial and entertainment district. Clarke Quay is known as the Lion City, as Clarke Quay is known for its excitement when it comes to life. But when the sun goes down, as each night is a celebration. Clarke Quay is famous for its nightlife, such as clubs, parties, and live concerts. As Clarke Quay is full of color lights and is attracted tourist people and as well as local people. We also see many people hopping around the food, restaurant, and as well as club. It's mostly crowded from Wednesday to Saturday nights. The overhead roof is made up of hill plastic construction, which look like a jellyfish with a massive fan. And it's come along with fountain. It attracts the crowds while they move from one place to another. Nowadays, Clarke Quay are filled with millennium young folks. Souk is a popular club in Clarke Quay, and mostly the teenager like to socialize in drinking and as well as entertainment music in the club. The major problems are the alcohol. Starting from Wednesday night, according to State Trump, they mentioned that there were people hanging out on Rich Beach at the Clarke Quay, though there was poster on the lamp and people ignored it. They said it was mainly foreigner and they gave an excuse that they were not aware of the Singapore law. A man who is 32. He mentioned that I didn't know about the rules and I will continue to drink since there are so many people here. He also said that he is living in Singapore on Wednesday and I want to enjoy myself first. 7-Eleven and Cheers knew about the brand rules and they can see the customer turning away and even they will ring to pay double price of the alcohol. The second issue is garbage dumping on the road. NEA also report to the State Trump that most litter bugs were caught, and it was cigarette butt, tissue paper, cigarette box wrapper, plastic cup, and water bottle. There are two solutions for them. The first solution is, according to New Liquor Control, Supply and Consumption Act, bans drinking in all public places from 10:30 p.m. to 7 a.m. The second solution is the government came with the strict rules, such as in April 2014, the government doubled the maximum fines of littering to $2,000 for the first conviction. Second conviction, $4,000. And 10,000 for the third and subsequent convictions. The reason they put up fine because they want to educate the younger people and make the Singapore environment more sustainable. To conclude this video, Clarke Quay is mostly managed one owned by CapitaLand Mall Asia. I believe that there is 1 million of people come to Singapore every month to experience Clarke Quay. But not only the Clarke Quay, but also to other famous places in Singapore. I'm sure the tourist people know about the pay fine of the country in Singapore. I myself is aware of the rules and regulation in Singapore. I also experienced Clarke Quay and it was tremendous nightlife to hang out with the friends. Hence, for the better development, the government need to implies more strict rules and regulation and make Singapore environment more sustainable. However, there is a term for nightlife. People, they often say the night is still young. Let's enjoy to the fullest.